Hey everybody, Mr. Delgadio back again, and I have something to show you. This is a homemade shaker that I just made. It's a little instrument, and today I'm going to show you how you could make your very own. So let's get started.
You will need a used toilet paper roll, some cardboard, some uncooked rice or uncooked beans, or you could use a little bit of both, a pair of scissors, a marker, and some glue. I'm using a glue gun, but you should definitely use regular school glue. Step one, you're gonna take a cup and make sure the cup is a little bit bigger than the toilet paper roll, and you're gonna trace a circle. Once you do that, you're gonna trace a second circle. Step two, you're gonna take the toilet paper roll and you're gonna put it inside your big circles and you're gonna trace smaller circles on the inside. And step three, you're gonna make little dotted lines in between the big circle and the little circle. And you'll see why in just a little bit. And it should look something like this. Step four, you're gonna take your scissors and you're gonna cut along the line of the bigger circles. Step five, you're gonna cut along the little dotted lines, being careful not to cut into the small circle. Once you do that, you could start to fold back the tabs. Step six, you're gonna begin to glue your circle to the toilet paper roll. Did I mention that you should definitely not use a hot glue gun and use regular school glue? And start making your way along the circle, gluing one tab at a time to the toilet paper roll. This part might be a little bit messy, so you'll probably want to ask a parent to help you out. Once you do that, you're gonna squeeze it tight along the edge and leave it alone for a few minutes so that it begins to dry. Step seven, pour your rice or your beans or a combination into the tube and only fill it up about halfway because your beads and rice are gonna need some room to shake around in there. Step eight, you're gonna glue the other circle to the other side of the tube. And step nine, the final step, you get to design your tube to look however you want. I put some smiley faces and some stars on mine, but you could be creative. You could use different colors and make it look however you like.
So now that you've got your own homemade shaker, let's talk about how to play it. So the secret to being a good shaker player is going forward and backwards. Some people think that you're supposed to go up and down or just shake it like a rattle, but you want to be able to play a groove, and that means you're going to go forward and backward. So see if you could do this as you say one and two and one and two and one and two and one and two and almost like a train. Chupa-chapa, chupa-chapa, chupa-chapa. And once you can do that, you could play along to some of your favorite music.
Shake, 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 Sinora, shake your body line. Shake, 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 Sinora, shake it all the time. Work, 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 Sinora, work your body line. Work, 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 Sinora, work it all the time. My girl's name is Sonora.
So have fun with that, and I'll see you next time.
And when she dances, oh brother.